Hello, Varsity Club members, and welcome to the second installment of Where Are They Now? I'm here at Busiglio Orthodontics in Brandon to visit with former football player Derek Busiglio. In a few moments, we're going to step inside and see what Derek's been up to since he's left USF.
Hey, Derek, how are you doing?
Camille, how are you?
Good to see you.
Solid, man. Solid. It's good to finally catch up with you.
My time at USF was exciting. Everything was new out there. I was actually at the school before the football team even got there. And I remember my high school coach Kelly telling me, hey, you need to go check out the program out there. And so walked into the coach's offices and saw Coach Levitt. And I told him, I said, hey, I want to come play football. And he said, I already have a team, you know. We don't need any help. So I came back again a couple weeks later. And he said, well, why don't we just give you a tryout? So he told Coach Lane to take me out, run me some hoops, do some things. And they said, okay, I think we'll have you come back out for winter conditioning. So I came back out for winter conditioning, and then they said, everything looks good, you know, but we need to go ahead and, now you're not on the team yet, we're going to have you come back for spring football. So I said, okay, we came back for spring football, performed well, and they said, well, okay. All right, well, we got summer workouts coming up. Let's have you come and evaluate you there. Good summer workouts, and finally ended up making the team. And actually with some of my other partners, Jay Mize was one of the guys that did that with me and walked on. But anyways, then we got going with the season, and it was just a lot of fun. It was a lot of new stuff all the time. And trying to balance that and education part of it was challenging, but definitely worth it. There's always been a big number of students, like 45,000 students, you know, approaching what UF is and stuff. So I always knew there's no reason in the world why this university can't be as big as the other state schools and compete at those levels. I think the fondest memory was the very first game at the old Sombrero. And all the linemen, we used to all kind of be up towards the front when we were coming out of the tunnel. Just remember that first game, me, and I'm pretty sure it was Kenyatta Jones, we ran out along with other people, but I mean, we were kind of right there in the very front, and just that place was, the sides were sold out. The end zones, they didn't sell them, but they sold out the entire sides. I forget, it was 52, 55,000 people, but it felt like a sellout because they never had those open anyway. It just, everybody went crazy, and we ran out, and I think Coach Patrick was there, and it was just, but I have this picture of, in my kitchen, actually, that day when we ran out and somebody took a picture, and I have it, and it just that was probably the fondest memory of is just starting the whole thing and running out there, starting the whole program.
Recently, Busiglio Orthodontist was named the finalist by Greater Brandon Chamber of Commerce for Small Business of the Year.
Enjoy getting the emails. They're informative, let you know what's going on, keeps your finger on the pulse. Seeing some of these, of some of my former teammates that I've seen come through here already doing these. The tailgates are a lot of fun, you know, running into people there. The food's good. You know, the whole experience of getting that whole tailgating experience going and getting that whole college football vibe really alive, and it's helping.
A special thank you to Dr. Derek Busiglio for his participation today, and thank you for tuning in to the September edition of Where Are They Now? For more information on Busiglio Orthodontics, please log on to theorthodoc.com. Be sure to check back in October for our next edition of Where Are They Now? For the Varsity Club, I'm Kamel Thompson.